And I distinctly remember at the time thinking, why do I feel like this? Because it didn't just kind of start becoming less annoying for me as it did for everybody else. It just kept becoming more and more annoying to the point where I really couldn't stand to even be around him. And it was really odd because I wasn't like this with anything else, and it was really strange for me. I was beginning to wonder if there was something wrong with me or something. And I thought, well, I'm just taking some time to get over this. Maybe it's because I'm of my distractibility with ADHD or something. But it still never really had that kind of an effect before, you know? And eventually, it kind of dawned on me that this thing wasn't going away. And it was particularly bad when I noticed other people's coughs. Because it's one of those things where you just tune it out. But when I started noticing everybody else's little individual coughs, I began to understand just how much people actually cough. And this is what the average person doesn't understand, that people cough constantly. And for me, it was a huge issue, because in school, if you can imagine having this kind of an odd, really odd response, where you would just get really upset just by hearing this sound, I couldn't hardly stand it. School became unbearable for me. I would try to sit through class as much as I could. If it became something where I was so agitated where I would either have to scream, get up and run out, or just kind of bury my head in my hands and not let anybody see how frustrated I was, particularly if I started crying. And you have to understand how odd this was for me, because I wasn't like that, you know? But the responses were so strong that if I didn't do something, I had to do something. It was just coming out, you know? And I had to try to make sure that people didn't notice it, because I was gonna cry anyway, because my choice is that I can at least choose between crying or screaming, and so I don't scream. But something happens. If I avoid screaming, then tears start running out of my face and I can't hardly help it. But, of course, eventually, some people noticed it, especially if I wound up glaring at somebody who was just really making me mad. And I didn't have any malice toward this person, but it was just so annoying that you can't hardly... You can't just calm yourself down and think to yourself logically, the problem is with me, it's not with anybody else. But you just get upset with people, and, you know, I never did anything to hurt anybody. I never even yelled at anybody. I just kind of kept everything to myself. But, you know, people would notice that there was an issue here and there. And, in fact, there were several people that went to the principal and complained and said that they were afraid of me. And because of that, I had to go and talk to the principal, and they had the counselor and everything there, and there was even a police officer there. And the reason why was because I'd actually spoken to them about my condition at a previous meeting with the principal earlier and told them about my issues. And then this time, though, when I went there, the issue was is they wanted me to go to a depression clinic, because they thought that maybe I could get some kind of help there, because, you know, nobody knows a damn thing about this problem. They just knew that there was an issue, and they thought that maybe they could at least figure out what was wrong with me. And so, of course, at the time, I'm a little naive about everything, so I'm like, yeah, okay, we'll go there. They might be able to do something for me. And it was a really distressing situation, though, because I hadn't really told anybody about this until I talked to the principal and the counselor and everything. And now, this time, they wanted me to actually go to a depression clinic. So, I'm like, okay, whatever. But the odd thing was that the reason why there was a police officer there was that because of the rules and regulations they have, regardless of the fact that I'd never threatened anybody or said anything really about the condition to anybody apart from the principal, you know, and the people who were there, it was still required that I actually be handcuffed and walked out to the police car, and then they would haul me in to the depression clinic where I would have to stay for at least a week, regardless of the fact that I had voluntarily went, and I could have rejected going altogether and wouldn't have had to have gone. But since you volunteer yourself to go, and because I had actually scratched my face at that time as well, because I really didn't have hardly any control over the condition at all then. I still don't have hardly a whole lot of control over it, but I have some, at least. And of course, the depression clinic was terrible. I mean, if you can imagine, most of the people who are in there are chain smokers, because they also have depressing issues, and so it's coughing all the time, and you're locked in with these people. There's only like a TV room, then there's a hallway, and then there's your individual bedrooms. Okay, but you couldn't close the room, and you were just kind of exposed all the time. So it was really odd, you know. It felt like I was another name for it, you know. A lot of people call it a psych ward. It may or may not actually be a psych ward, but there was actually a crazy guy in there. So it was really off-putting, you know. I'm not crazy. I just have this particular issue. I have this illness associated with the noises.